R2 Integrated Corridor Management, or ICM champions, Emma and Wolfgang, have established a regional ICM stakeholder coalition group. This group meets monthly, working towards their shared goal of more integrated and effective management for a critical congested corridor. Let's check in with the group, as their discussion turns to a complex topic critical to their ICM vision.
Last time we met, I briefly touched on the concept of a decision support system, or DSS. Several of you asked for a deeper dive on this topic.
Ah, yes. When I was in the military, model-driven decision support systems helped us model various scenarios related to moving and positioning supplies.
Aren't data-driven decision support systems used to speed up medical diagnoses? I'm also familiar with tools in the logistics industry to optimize delivery routes. Are these examples of DSS?
Correct. In general, a DSS is any information system that supports decision-making activities.
Okay, but how does it work in the ICM context?
The DSS monitors traffic conditions in the corridor, looking for data patterns out of the ordinary. When an incident or other congestion-causing event is detected, the DSS models and recommends alternative actions to be taken in response.
How do we know these solutions aren't some crazy robot fever dream? Beam me up, Scotty.
We would restrict solutions to strategies that we all agree could be implemented by our agencies in real time. The DSS uses these business rules when formulating solutions.
For example, in the case of a major incident in the Komodo Tunnel, the DSS may model and recommend both a coordinated multi-channel traveler information plan and activating hard shoulder running on the approach to the Victory Island Bridge. We would use a transportation model of some sort to predict the impacts of various alternatives.
Hard shoulder running won't be of any help there, unless we also change our signal timings near the bridge.
Great point, Diego. The DSS will consider a full range of responses and zero in on the ones that combine strategies best.
I see. The robots offer what they think are good strategies, but we humans still get to make the final call. Set phases to stun.
It's clear Hua has watched way too much science fiction. But seriously, it sounds critical that we establish our DSS business rules.
Absolutely. The business rules are the agreements between agencies or organizations on roles and responsibilities and operational practices, given certain corridor conditions or situations. Business rules define the context and constraints for DSS implementation.
Business rules establish the ways in which agencies communicate, coordinate, and share information.
Okay. I think I understand. Imagine a chessboard. The pieces are all of us, the managers, operators, agencies, with their own capabilities. The game rules are the business rules by which we all agree to play or operate.
That's right. Basically, the DSS receives traffic data, measures the corridor performance, and checks whether it is meeting desired performance targets. If not, then it evaluates response plans and provides a recommended plan to all of us, based on the previously agreed upon business rule strategies. And it will do all of this continuously in real time.
After we identify the target corridor and its boundaries, the first step is identifying the ICM partners, like those of us in the room today, and any others we are missing. These include partners we don't work with on a regular basis in traffic operations. Like parking, on-demand services, and emergency service providers. Who can represent parking management in our team right now?
Well, I guess I could, because the city sets the parking policy downtown. But I'm in operations, so I don't really know the details of what Cassandra and her team are doing over in the parking office.
Good example. Is Cassandra someone we should be inviting to our team to develop business rules?
I think we should. Drivers have to park somewhere at the end of their trips. Plus, Cassandra and I are both on the science fiction film board for the City Center Cinema. I see her all the time. Let me ask her.
Hua, your obsession with science fiction is finally paying off.
We come in peace, Cassandra. For ICM.
Great work, everyone. To get started on DSS, the Federal Highway Administration has published some good advice for us. Agencies should consider incremental, long-term DSS development. Testing some of the agreed-upon business rules under various conditions to see how they will work in practice prior to programming them into the DSS. Consider the associated costs and resources needed, as DSS often requires recalibrating a traffic model or other parameters. Traffic model feeds should be consistent with the regional modeling and simulation efforts tool for an effective DSS. If possible, use the same tool. An effective DSS may require the use of enhanced traffic modeling capabilities, which may be a long-term resource for the area. Incorporating stakeholder-developed business rules will enhance the backers' acceptance, reduce uncertainties, and boost DSS strategies' effectiveness. Using multimodal performance measures to drive response plans decision-making, which provides a valuable way to evaluate DSS effectiveness from both a predictive and a retrospective viewpoint. That's all good advice. But can we walk through an example of a DSS in action? Today, when there is a major incident, the mayor's office calls a meeting to plan a response strategy. But it would be great if the DSS could make these decisions in real time.
I have some materials from a recent visit to the Big River Transportation Management Center. The TMC has implemented a DSS there specifically for incident response.
Big River has a DSS. I had no idea. How does it work?
The Big River DSS constantly mines real-time data from detectors, monitoring speeds, and weather conditions. When triggered, the DSS will model alternative solutions as compared to the do-nothing alternative.
Right. Sometimes the best thing to do is stick with your current plan. An overreaction can make things worse.
If the DSS predicts that alternative solutions are moderately better than the do-nothing alternative, an ICM coordinator would recommend the best outcome solution.
Well, one of our first actions should be to find someone to be a real-time ICM coordinator. That's not even a job we have in our TMC.
True. Once the ICM coordinator approves the decision, then the DSS pushes candidate response plan information to the involved agency users for plan implementation in real time.
Interesting. Can we form a tiger team specifically to tackle business rules and DSS planning? I'll volunteer to organize and lead it. Absolutely, Sylvia. Perfect. Well, I can't let my brother-in-law up in Big River find out that they have something more advanced than what we have here in Alligator City. I'll never hear the end of it at our family reunion.
Sylvia, now we know what really motivates you.
You just heard Emma, Wolfgang, and the Tiger teams discussing using a decision support system to implement ICM. See you in segment 4, where we will discuss successful incremental deployment of ICM over time.